Hello everyone and welcome to this week's Adobe Scripting Quick Tip Tutorial. In this one, I'm going to be showing you a bit of a little hack to get any installed fonts on your system using a script. Now you can run this script in any program, like for example here, I can run it in After Effects, and I have a drop down with a nice UI of all of my installed fonts. And I could do this in any other app that supports scripts. And the secret is that we're going to use BridgeTalk to talk to InDesign, or if you want, you can talk to any other program like Illustrator or Photoshop that offers you a list of all the fonts, and we're going to write them to a file, read that file into a dropdown, and then have access to that in any other program. So a prerequisite to this is that you do have InDesign, Illustrator, or some other Adobe program that gives you the actual font information, because for example, After Effects, there's no way to access the fonts, and so that's why we're going to use this. Now, of course, just to be clear, this is only for scripts. If you're using extensions, you can use things like Node.js and other tools to get all the system fonts. This is strictly speaking for a script, which you can run in any application and get a list of all the fonts, assuming you have, at least in this vanilla case, InDesign installed. Before we get started, I do want to remind you down below, hit subscribe and the bell icon to be notified of new videos coming out twice weekly on the channel. And down in the description, you can check out the code for this, download it for yourself, modify it for other applications other than just InDesign if you want. And you can follow us there on GitHub for coding updates, as well as Instagram in the description for other live updates. If you're not a member of the Discord server, you can come and join and get help with scripting, extensions, plugins, expressions, and much more. Shout out to all of our VIPs and other members. We currently have 9. And speaking of members, you can become one in the description. You can become a member supporter, and this helps us out financially as well as gives you perks for supporting us. So the way, again, this is going to basically work is we're interfacing using BridgeTalk, which is ability to talk between Adobe applications and send messages and code. And we're going to write all the fonts into a fonts file. And to illustrate this, I'm going to delete my fonts file, which is going to be located on the desktop. And if I go ahead and say, make sure I have all my apps closed here, I'm going to link this to After Effects. I want to get a UI in After Effects with all my fonts. So I'll connect it and run the script. And as you can see, it's going to actually launch InDesign first thing. And right now, our dropdown is empty. That's because it's busy reading however many fonts I have. I think it's most systems have somewhere between like 400 to 1,000 fonts if you have Adobe stuff installed. So if we just wait a moment while InDesign is loading all of our fonts, you can even see on our desktop, we have a fonts file created, and now we just have to be a little bit patient as it loads all these fonts. Now, the way the script is set up is so that it only will create this fonts file if it doesn't exist. If once we run this and it sets up all the fonts, lists them out, it's not gonna spend this however long it takes setting up all the fonts every time. Now that we've waited probably 30 to 60 seconds, we now will have them all automatically loaded into our installed fonts dropdown. And if I close it and run it again, it's going to recognize the fonts file already exists. So we're just going to read everything from it. And if you go to your desktop where it's been created, our fonts file is just the same list here. And this contains all of our fonts in the PostScript name. If you wanted to, you can adjust the code just to get the normal font name, but usually to apply or use a font and change the text in your application, you need the PostScript name. So that's just how we can do that. You can even run this specifically in like ExtendScript and just get all your fonts in any application you choose. And also a bonus, if you didn't see, there's a random button in this UI, so you can hit random and get a random font displayed, which is pretty neat when you have hundreds of fonts to choose from. But that's gonna do it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, hit the thumbs up button down below, hit subscribe and the bell icon to be notified of new videos coming out twice weekly on the channel. And down in the description, you can check out the code for this, try it out for yourself, make modifications for other applications, see if you can find any faster workarounds. And of course, follow us there on GitHub for other coding updates. And also in the description, you can follow us on Instagram for other updates as well. If you're not a member of our Discord server, you can come and join and get help with scripting, extensions, plugins, expressions, and much more. And if you want to help support the channel and get cool perks, you can become a member, supporter, premium supporter, or VIP, link in the description. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you guys next time.